On this week's episode, we start out rough. Peggy doesn't know how to walk. Sorry, Peggy, but she took three steps and the third one wasn't a step. So I start off at the urgent care. She finally got out, not broken, not sprained, but she can't move it and she can't walk. So, okay.
It's psychosomatic, you know.
No, it's turning black and blue and swelling up. But from there, we get on the subject, and then Scott says we didn't talk about something, which I know we talked about. And then Scott says he'll go back and look, but we all know Scott won't go back and look.
Because I'll forget.
Because he'll forget, because he forgot about this.
However, sometimes if I see it when I'm doing the editing, I do check stuff out.
Well, what are we taking the bets on that Scott goes back and finds it?
Which reminds me, have you folks noticed that the editing looks different? It's not right yet, but it's looking different.
Yeah, he's figuring out the editing, new editing software. So thank you for that. It's
supposed to be so much easier. No.
No.
Well, it's probably because for 5 freaking years I've been doing it the other way. So learning the new thing is like,
But our show is here to get you get away. Enjoy this 4th of July show.
Please.
Fireworks free, politics free, and religion free.
Mostly.
Welcome to the Don't Know Show. I'm Steve, maybe not.
And I'm Scott, for sure. And this is a tale of how bad life decisions led to a YouTube show, a podcast, and a live Twitch stream.
Yes, and we're going to talk about what we've noticed is going on in the world today, what's coming up in the world, and whatever else the hell we want to talk about. Not talk about politics, not talk about religion. We're going to try and get you to relax, get away from all the crazinesses out there. So don't watch the news. Watch us. Go down to whathappened.world. Did you figure that out? I haven't had a chance to look yet.
Yes, at least some of it. The one that we're doing right now, it works.
Good. Go down to whathappened.world and you can connect to our social media and you can see what we're doing and see what Scott doesn't post or does post. You can see my posts or not posts. We got a live Twitch stream going right now with a chat. So you can go on to Twitch and go to STE for Fun Guy and see that.
That's the number 4, by the way.
Yes, STE for Fun Guy. What happened? Just said hello. Anyone there? The reason we are discombobulated today, Twitch and YouTube. How's it going, ST? So just you and me.
Jeannie's there.
The reason we are discombobulated is because my wife took 3 steps and accidentally made it 2.5 steps. The third step, she rolled over her foot and smashed into the side of my car. And now she can't flex her foot up or down. So we were just over at urgent care. They said no break, no strain. They said rice it. No big deal. Thank you for the help. I just paid $400 to go to a doctor to say, rest it, ice it, compress it, and elevate it. Oh, okay, thanks.
Yeah, we already knew to do that. We were just making sure things were good.
Yeah. So,
but that's what your insurance is for, you know.
I'm not worried about paying for it. I'd hate to see, I'd hate to see anybody in pain.
Yes.
And
hence the vodka comment earlier.
Not be able to go to work.
Oh, that would be bad.
She will not be able to go to work tomorrow if it continues like this. She doesn't even know how to use crutches anymore. It's pretty funny. I find that amusing. But as I said, we're going to talk about what we know is going on in the world today. Get you distracted from all that crazy stuff that's going on. So enough about my crazy day. And do you want to talk about your crazy day
before
we
enough?
Talk about the pictures behind
No, us? I don't want to talk about my day because I don't want to remember it anymore.
Cool. All right. So question for you.
Answer for you.
What is your picture about behind you?
Well, you noticed I made the comment several times for the past couple of shows that we're in a drought.
Okay.
You noticed that my backyard, the grass is mostly brown.
Well, that's dirt, Scott. I don't know how if you know this, but
this is grass.
That's dirt.
That's grass. This is dirt.
Yeah. Okay. Dirt is brown. Grass is tan.
Okay. Now, here's another thing that's kind of interesting.
Straw colored.
You notice that my garden doesn't seem to have any weeds.
That's a good thing.
Well, it is, but it's because of the drought. And what I'm doing is instead of watering the whole garden, I'm watering each individual plant So the rest of the dirt is bone dry. So the weeds don't even grow in it. That's how much of a drought we're in.
Yeah, it's a weird year. But yet it poured yesterday. The Cubs game was rain delayed.
Yep, but missed us.
Did you get rained by you?
Nope. Completely missed us.
So south of you.
And east. It did hit Milwaukee, too. It hit Chicago and Milwaukee. But, you know, it was only like 30 miles from the lake. And we're like 60, so.
That is crazy.
We could have used that rain.
Oh, yeah, that's what they say when you get old. Oh, we needed the rain. It's rain, but we needed the rain. That's how you know when you're old.
Yeah.
When you start saying that. You start saying that, you go, well, but we needed the rain.
Yes, yes.
So. All right.
But it is nice because my garden, I have other pictures, close-ups of some of the individual plants, but I'm not going to put them up there. But things are growing. We had our first tomato already. We're picking the first pepper. I should have picked it today, and I forgot to go get it.
Pick a peck of pickled peppers?
And we got some jalapenos that are almost ready. We've got a couple of cucumbers that are like 2 inches long, so they got a ways to go. Ooh. But it's getting there.
All righty. Well, I've got some show subjects open so we can get going into that. Oh, even
ooh, as well. What about the picture behind you?
There you go. Now you asked, finally. I wonder when you're going to ask me about that. That is where we were going when Peggy took a misstep and destroyed her foot.
Okay. So you were going to go drown her instead? That doesn't sound very nice.
Well, had she made that misstep there, that could have happened.
Yeah.
So, Chicago NASCAR. What about Chicago NASCAR? Is NASCAR in Chicago this week?
Maybe.
They do an oval there. It's a short track.
Anything like the short bus?
I have no idea. Live.
Live, yes. Woohoo. Is it live or is it memories? I mean, Memorex.
The rain is live? Will you guys have fake rain there?
Fake rain, yep.
64 out of 75. I have no idea what she's talking about.
54 out of 75 laps. Or 64 out of 75. So it's almost done.
Yeah, I see that. I'm watching it here. It's called the Grant Park 220.
Ooh.
The Xfinity Series. And Jay Haley is, Elliot Logano, third for Kyle Busch. Finally see some
220. Is that a 2.5 mile lap then?
It's a short oval. It's a.
Yeah. Well, it can't be that short if it's 2.5 miles.
I don't know how big it is. It is laps 100. Distance is 220 miles. Okay, so this is the Grant Park. So the Grant Park 220 is supposed to be 220 miles. 100 laps. Length is 2.2 miles.
Yeah, so essentially, if it's 2.25.
I want to see a picture.
That is short, yeah.
It says it's a street course. Oh, so it looks like they're shortening it because of the rain. But I can't find the track. I can't find a picture of track. So it's a street course actually out on, that's why it's called Grant Park, because it actually is.
It makes sense.
Chicago street course. Let's see if they have it on the map here. No, that's so nice. They show Chicago Street Course. They don't show.
Why should we give you any information? You don't need information. Just listen to what we tell you.
So that's cool. Okay. So those are fun courses. Those are fun races.
Yes.
All right. Well, yes. Yeah, so, yes, yeah, she could have fallen in the pool and drowned because she wouldn't have been able to stand up. So, therefore, even a foot of water, she would have drowned.
Well, no. She could have stood up on one leg in the water. You're bleeped in the water.
She couldn't. No, she just can't even use the crutches right.
She can pretend she is a flamingo.
No, she cannot. However, so that's me. I was at the pool and 2 days in a row at the pool, and so far 2 injuries.
Okay, you're on. I'm
not really an injury, but I realized that my shoulder crack 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 crack. So my shoulder got sore yesterday.
So what today, you're telling me is your shoulder is now a salt or pepper grind.
It kind of felt like it.
Okay.
When you put your hand on it, and I did that, you could feel it going. So
nice.
Yeah, not good. So I didn't do that today, and it feels better. But
so you're going to have to stop bringing Arthur with you when you go play.
Yep. So there's that. So those are the pictures behind us. But what amazing thing is happening in the next few days, which by the time this gets to YouTube, it'll be over already.
Let me guess. The aliens are coming.
Well, if you're in Vegas, yes, that's what they've been saying.
Yes.
That aliens have landed in people's backyards here.
Yes. Well, you know, because the aliens come on Independence Day.
No.
That's what the movie said twice.
No. No, it's more than a one-day war. That's when we defeat them.
Ah.
But look what I found.
I was just preparing. Since you were slow on getting it up. Oh, looky, a map.
So it goes down Columbus Drive, Balboa Drive, Lakeshore Drive, comes back around, dips around. Is that a bridge over Michigan Avenue? It's got to be, right? But I don't know if they closed.
That's Michigan Avenue. That's a river.
Oh, that's a river. That's Michigan Avenue. Yeah, so that's a bridge over the river.
And then you know, the bridge over troubled water?
You do a little loop right there and then back around. So kind of a cool little track.
I wonder what the top speed is on that thing, because it's not a very... They can't go that fast.
Questions. Because now you know I'm going to have to look it up.
Exactly. See, I'm trying to keep you preoccupied.
So I can't get to the first subject of our thing?
Well, no. For a different reason.
Okay, go ahead.
But Goober's left, so it's okay now. I needed to lean forward in order to do stuff on the computer, and as long as you were distracted, I didn't have to, and Goober could stay. I came up with a solution because his nails cut. I wear shorts, obviously, because it's summer, and his nail scratched up my legs. So I now have a towel here stretched between my legs, and there's a little indentation where he jumps in there and just sort of plops in there like a cat would, and he really likes it. Huh. I take care of my bunny. Answers. Oh, those are train tracks, not the river. Aha.
Oh, yeah, those are the train tracks.
Yep, yep, yep. Jeannie knows things.
Yep, I'm looking at the... Because she's watching the race.
Oh, that makes perfect sense. You could see things.
So she is actually seeing that it's train tracks. Yeah, the river...
So what color is the car in the
river? Because the river is farther down. The river is more by, like, Canal, thus the name Canal Street, and Wacker.
Right.
So, doesn't say... Ticket okay. Prices start at $269 and go up from there. You probably won't get within a 6-block. Wow.
Well, Gravedigger's here. He wants to know what we're talking about.
Hey, Gravedigger.
Yeah.
Shoot the Zoom invite. Did you shoot the Zoom invite?
Ow. Why are you nibbling on my leg?
Did you shoot it?
No, I didn't shoot it.
It says he asked you to shoot it.
Oh.
Shoot the Zoom invite. Shoot it.
Okay. Do.
Right now, we were talking about the race in Chicago, the NASCAR race that's going on in Chicago that was rain delayed, just like the Cubs game yesterday was rain delayed. But yeah, now and we're talking about the pool behind me, and that's the water we have in the desert. And then we're talking about Scott's tan grass, which he called brown. I said, no, that's dirt. That's brown. And now you're back at the beginning of the show. So there you go.
Yay.
So cool. So what is coming up? Independence Day?
Yes, July 4th coming up. It's actually technically tomorrow.
July 4th is coming up for all countries.
Yes.
However, Independence Day is celebrated in the United States.
Correct.
And on that day, that is the day that we claim that we took independence from England for no taxation without representation. And right now we just get taxed like crazy with representation.
Which is awesome, right?
But we said we wouldn't talk politics, so cool.
We don't do politics.
Cool. All right, so what was I gonna say? Oh, so 4th of July. And what is the big contest that happens on the 4th of July? In New York?
Oh, in New York. A contest in New York. Who could shoot the biggest firework off the top of the Empire State Building?
Seriously? How do you not know this?
Are you talking about the ketchup and cola?
No. That's not a contest.
Oh, that's what I was wondering. It's like, what the heck?
I'm talking about the contest that happens every year on the 4th of July in New York.
Yeah. I didn't know anything about the contest in New York. I don't pay attention.
You don't know who Joey Chestnut is?
I do not.
You don't know how many hot dogs he ate?
I don't know him, so I don't know how many hot dogs he ate.
What? You don't know about the Nathan's hot dog eating contest that's been going on in New York?
No.
Seriously.
Seriously.
No, you know about it. You choose to ignore me. I talk about it every year.
No, we talk about Vienna hot dogs.
No, Nathan's hot dog contest. And I talked about last year. Remember when the guy in the Darth Vader mask went up there and Joey was eating and he had a protest sign and Joey put him in a headlock and kept eating and still won?
Don't recall.
On our show last year.
I'm going to look it up now.
Thank you for paying attention to our show.
Mm-mm. Since I'm the one that does the editing, I usually remember what's on them. If you bring it up to me, remind me. I don't remember that at all.
It was on the show.
Okay. I'll look it up.
Okay. You owe me what if I'm right?
What
do I owe you if I'm wrong?
When we go golfing, I won't beat you too bad.
I told you, if you beat me, my punishment is I will never pick up a golf club again. Ever again.
Except to hit me over the head with, right?
No. No, if you're that good, which you're not, you're doing something wrong.
Of course I am.
I don't know what it is. But
if I was doing it right, I'd be golfing in the 70s.
No. No, you wouldn't. You know, 72 is par, right?
That is correct.
You say this like, and then you told me the other day that the first time you've never lost a golf ball. People ever. Who lose golf balls do not shoot in the 80s. Thank you.
You only lose two balls. That's only two strokes.
You're cheat. More than two strokes. You've got to assess the penalties strokes. Correctly.
Well.
You just guess how many. Well, I know I took four shots in the fairway, but I could have got it here in two. So I'm going to be two on the green.
It's usually the other way around. I usually get on the green pretty good. I just can't putt.
And then I know I took four putts, but the first putt was only 30 feet away. That should have been a gimme. So I'll take that as a par.
Yeah. Well, it makes perfect sense because I usually sink the long putts. I can't make the short putts.
No. No. So then you have no idea what the record of hot dogs is.
I'm going to say, how much time is it, by the way? 5 minutes?
I forget how long it is. How many hot dogs, how much time? It's not very long. I think it's like 10 minutes. Let's see. How many minutes? How? Don't talk while I'm doing this. Seriously.
You said not to talk. I didn't talk. I listened to you.
No, you don't. You never listen to me.
I always listen to you. I just forget what you say all the time. My brain's got overfilled with information.
All right, Nathan's 10 minutes. Yeah, 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
Okay.
27.
You could eat 27 hot dogs in 10 minutes.
No, I could probably eat 4 and then I'd be full.
I find that hard to believe.
I usually only eat 2. Of course, they're not using buns, right? They're just eating the hot dogs.
No.
Bun and everything.
Buns, okay. They're just dressed up. Yeah. It's just hot dogs and buns, and they have drinks to help lubricate it down.
Wash it down, right, yeah. No, I only eat 2 hot dogs, and I'm full. Well, of course, I got fries with that, but 2 hot dogs and fries and then soda is the beverage is my lunch when I go to Brody's.
But you could eat more than that.
I could probably eat 1/3.
Seriously? All you can eat is 3 hot dogs?
I don't eat that much food at a time.
What, do you just constantly eat them?
No, I just eat really high caloric shit.
Oh, because you're a picky eater.
Yes.
All right, the record was 63. He says this year he's going to beat it with 76.
Okay. As in 1776?
Joey Chestnut finished in 7 years, 63 hot dogs and buns. He set his record the previous year at 76. Yeah, it was 63 because he's going to buy. So he says he's going to beat that record. So that'll be interesting.
It's insane.
Yeah, you got to watch it. It's freaking hilarious.
I do know that these guys train for it because you got to stretch your stomach out.
Well, the funny part is this guy is such a freaking beast of a competitive eater. Since that Japanese dude left, that was put in competition, I think the nearest guy is like 20 hot dogs
right
below him or something like that. It's like not even close.
I sort of remember seeing a hot dog eating contest on like one of Susie's Hallmark movies. And the ringer dude was like a sumo wrestler and he just kept shoving him in his face.
How many White Castles can you eat? You eat a sack?
I can eat 4 double cheeseburgers.
So you could eat a sack. You could eat 10 hamburgers. Or won't you eat hamburgers?
Yeah, I'm. For some odd reason, the double just tastes so much better.
I understand the taste. I'm not talking about taste. I'm talking about.
I know, because you're not supposed to be eating
swallowing it in 10 minutes.
To get them in your mouth, right? So, yeah, you're probably right. I could probably do a crave. They're called craves, not cases. Cases are the huge ones. I guess it is a crave case, right?
I said a sack.
Or sack. A sack.
A sack is 10.
Sack is 10.
Crave case is 30.
Ooh. Yeah, that'd be a lot.
I don't know, show.
What I usually do is I usually get the number 2, which is 2 double cheeseburgers, a fry, and a drink. And sometimes I'll eat a 3rd one. See the things you can learn about my eating habits by watching our show.
Jalapeno cheese sliders, 6 sliders, 3 2-packs.
Yeah, they have those at the grocery store.
For microwaves. Free combo. Where's the menu?
Menu? Did you push the menu button?
That's a crave case. See the case?
Yep. There we go.
Oh, menu.
Menu.
See?
Yep. I get a combo.
Combos.
Big craves. Those are crave cases. Oh, look. They even have a thing called a clutch.
The hell is that?
It looks like a purse.
This looks like a purse to you. Okay. How many purses have speakers and cassettes on them?
Yeah, okay. It was blurry at first. It takes a while for it to come on to clean on the screen.
And a clutch is 20.
Okay.
Okay, bottom by the side. There's the... Oh, let's check that out. So there's the case, like I said, 30. Right. 30 sliders.
Right.
Check this out. A Crave crate.
Ooh, a crate. 100. Woohoo! Is that what you had at the wedding? Did you get those or weren't they available yet?
No, these weren't available when Peggy and I got married.
Because I know you had an awful lot of them.
Yes, I did. In stores today. So there you go. Don't question me about food, dude. The Don't Know Show knows food.
Yes, it does.
I didn't get to be fat without knowing food. But
I'm surprised you didn't marry a donut.
Did you see what Pepsi is doing for the 4th of July?
We talked about this last week.
We did?
Dang. I remember talking about it, but I don't know who. Maybe it wasn't you.
Wasn't to me.
Okay.
Wasn't on the show. You don't even pay attention to the show when you talk about stuff.
Go figure.
All right. Pepsi introduces how do you pronounce it? Colachup.
Is a mixture of, well, it's obviously Pepsi Cola mixed with ketchup.
It is ketchup infused
with
Pepsi. And it's Heinz ketchup too, which is good ketchup.
Yep.
So does that mean the 57 varieties is now 58?
58. Certainly is, Ollie.
That is gross. At my mother's memorial, we did a case.
Yeah, they only did a case at mom's memorial.
Yeah.
But yeah, who thinks of this stuff?
Crazy people like us.
The Pepsi team teamed up with the Culinary Institute of America Consulting to create a condiment that beverage company says is ideal to put on a hot dog. Why don't you just do like Joey does and just dip the dog instead of water to get it to go down?
Yep. Pepsi. Sure.
That is crazy. You know, Pepsi sells more than Coke when it comes to cans and bottles.
Yes.
The only reason that Coke is bigger is because of fountain sales.
It's like 10 to 1 on the fountain sale.
Yeah, it's amazing. But, I got to show you the picture.
Okay.
This is amusing to me. There it is. Pepsi Zero Sugar. Colachup.
Yep.
Pepsi Cola Infused Ketchup.
Yuck. How cool is that, right?
No.
Look at the difference in color, too.
No.
It makes it more of a...
No.
Red, it's a different color. Have you ever noticed that the ketchup that gets stuck on the top of the ketchup bottle for a week, that's the color that the new stuff is?
No. Just no.
Okay. So what else do we got going on? I see you got July 4th gifts.
So that was July 4th. Was that
it? It's close.
So when did this become a thing? Okay. All of a sudden they're telling me I need to buy 4th of July gifts.
Sure.
What do you mean, sure? When did
we have a problem with high inflation and low sales. So people have to come up with new ideas to get you to buy things.
4th of July gifts for large bubble. A USA beer cap map. How about a USA map coloring mug?
Sure.
A cooler with a flag design on it. A patriotic candy bouquet. Here's one that you should give for the 4th of July. A map of the U.S. What? Engraved decanter? Okay, that's kind of cool.
Yeah, that was cool.
But when do you buy a 4th of July doormat? Here. Okay. Ticket to ride. When I think 4th of July games, I think ticket to ride.
Sure. He's got a ticket to ride.
Okay, that's England. Hot sauce. Boston Tea Party gift set. Okay, that's kind of cool for a, you know, tea party, you know.
Sure.
Iconic landmark scratch-off poster. 4th of July shirts. Okay. You look like the 4th of July.
You look like a hot dog. Okay.
You look like the 4th of July.
You the hot dog, though?
No. Gnomes.
Gnomes.
Heart favors.
Patriotic gnomes.
What? Wait. I'm like, wait, what? Look at page after page. Look at all the best baseball barbecue. I mean, that's pretty cool. But this is... Hand tool chest, dice, outdoor dice.
You're into a different map thing.
Yeah, but it's still 4th of July.
Oh.
4th of July, spread joy everywhere.
Okay.
These are fun facts. Look, even Vogue. So at least theirs kind of made sense, right? 24th of July, host gift ideas that'll win you best guess, right? So if you're invited to somebody's barbecue, you can bring over these mugs.
Sure. Of
course. Or their candles. So maybe they're bug candles. I don't know. Oh, look at the little coasters of bugs.
Okay.
An ashtray of dying flowers. Wait. I don't even know what these straws are. They're just straws. I mean, slip-ons? Pamp-shaped croissant light.
Okay.
It's a light. A summer deck of cards. All the different winter, summer. Really? A leaf plate? No, I mean, really, Scott?
Really? 100%. I think we should buy several of each of those and give them away.
Who makes a mug with a handle that small?
Made in China.
Of course, it's Vogue, though. I'm not buying anybody 4th of July gifts, just so you know. Sorry. Not happening.
That's right. Besides, you still got, you know, all those fireworks that you can be giving away.
Yeah. I have no idea where we are in time because we started
time.
Late and weird.
It's time for what? The genuine positivity message from Funguy The Entertainer.
Which he wrote after he stopped being mad.
Yes.
So it's because
it would not have been a good positivity message earlier today. Not even close.
Okay.
Reaching for the stars might be easier if you have a spacecraft, but making that reach without one is how the best things start.
I feel better already.
Yay.
Yeah.
My work here is done.
Is it?
No. Oh. We still got another half an hour of the show.
Oh. All right, where are we on the list then?
We are now at number 3.
Should we do that?
And you're like, they're not numbered, you know.
Or should we spin the wheel?
Oh, yeah, we should spin the wheel. Where did it go? I don't see it. Is it down far?
It's underneath number 3.
Oh, it's there it is.
Number 4.
Number 4.
But again, they're not numbered.
They're not numbered.
All right, so yeah, I have no idea if it's got all the subjects on there or not. So let's just go with it and see what we get.
Okay. It is now officially shared. And here comes live on your screen. You see it?
Uh-oh. I see it, but I... Oh, there we go. It went full screen and screwed up my whole thing.
Uh-oh.
Classic commercials. Is that what it says?
I haven't spun it yet.
Oh, well, are you going to spin it?
Sure. I was just waiting for you to be ready.
Well, for what?
Because you like to watch it. It's like hypnotic for you.
No, I'm looking at the other stuff. Okay, you were talking about your garden today. Right?
Left.
All right, let me see. Flowers. No.
No.
No. No, no, no.
Okay, that's kind of weird. I canceled the... never mind.
Gotta unshare it.
Yes, I just closed the window, so it went to a different window.
All right, and I need to figure out how to do this again.
Oh no, brown cow.
All right. These are popular flowers.
Okay.
And let's see if Scott knows. Because what is the name of the segment, Scott?
Does Scott know?
Right. So, I'm hoping you know this one.
That is a lily.
What kind of lily?
It's a white lily.
Or a calla lily.
Calla lily. Okay.
You knew that. You've said that before.
Yes, I have.
That's why I thought you might know that one. Okay, why is this not? Okay. This one you should know.
Oh, it's a calla lily. That looks like a daisy, but it
very
might.
Good. It is a daisy.
Is that a gardenia?
What? You wear them as boutonnieres.
That's a carnation? That is a terrible picture of a carnation.
Too bad.
I mean, honestly, they look like they have faces in them. That is a violet.
What?
No, not violet. Hang on. Damn it. I grew those things, too. They're a bitch to grow.
I know. That's why I'm picking ones that I think you should know.
Oh, what the hell are they called? Come on. I'm brain dead.
They're very hard to grow. Starts with the letter O.
Orchid. Those are orchids?
Yep. Now you know what those are. Those are Liberace's favorite thing on the piano.
Well,
actually is organ.
Yes, on the organ, right. Food it. That is very naughty, Steve.
You said it first.
That is a rose. It is actually a long stem rose.
This one you'll know.
That is a sunflower.
I will agree with you that this is a bad picture of it. So I will give you hints on this one. What the?
Okay.
But very bad pictures.
Interesting. It is not ringing a bell at all. And they're from around here?
Oh, God. Why is this? Hang on. Trying to get you a better picture here. This picture should do it. It's a fundraiser flower.
Oh, it's a poppy.
Very good.
Yeah, that first picture is definitely not.
That's what I said. It wasn't a very good picture. What is wrong with my computer today?
Peggy probably kicked it.
This one. Come on. You already guessed it. What color is that?
Well, it's a violet.
And I think that's about all of them. You might know this from your time in Chicago.
My kind of town, Chicago is. Oh, lilacs.
Very good.
And that's actually Lombard.
Lombard.
A lilac city.
This is for the holidays. Again, terrible picture.
Poinsettias.
Yep. There you go. So Scott knows flowers.
Yay.
So did you take it off of the wheel or did you leave it on the wheel?
I left it on.
All right. Well, if it comes up again, you'll have to take it off. I'm not cleaning up your mess.
I was concentrating on getting the questions right.
Well, you didn't have any questions.
Well, sort of. All right. What do we got next?
Nothing.
We're done?
Nope.
Oh, we're just going to sit here and chat about the weather?
It wasn't a weather balloon. I keep telling you that. Oh, even though China says it's a weather balloon.
Yes, yes. That's what they say. Well, technically, they are weather balloons, but they're weather balloons that have been modified for special purposes.
So you've seen this, right? China has put another weather balloon up over, but this time it is flying over Asia.
Okay.
Where's China?
It's in the Orient.
It's in Asia.
Yeah, duh.
But
they're spying on themselves.
But they're saying that this one was flying over Taiwan.
Yes.
And no, you know that this is the politics thing.
Yes.
But you know that they're saying, oh, we're gonna go get Taiwan back. But I mean, that doesn't look like a spy balloon at all. This looks like a weather balloon. But pay no attention to that gathering. Yeah. Information stuff.
Oh, yeah, right. All that high technology stuff. Here's what's really funny. I mean, if you think about it, putting a spy plane up there cost $1 billion. You could do an awful lot of spy balloons with $1 billion.
Okay, here's my question for you.
Sure.
Can you have plausible deniability that a balloon just happened to float with the wind or that a plane directly flew over you? Which one can you go, it's a balloon. It's got a mind of its own. It's a plane. It's got a mind of its own. Which one?
It does. There's AI. You know that your buddy Al is running these things and he just went crazy.
That's the picture. Why is this advertisement open? How do I close that? Get out of here. God, what an annoying advertisement.
Yes, I agree. And what makes it the most annoying is you can't find the closeout button.
Good to go away. But look, that's the picture of it. That could be a picture of anything. Satellite image of suspected spy balloon.
No, right.
This is when it was over Japan. So, yeah. Kind of funny.
Well.
Funny.
Yeah. C'est la vie.
All right. So. I was going to need this one.
Is we going to talk about Mars?
I don't know where you're at in the show subjects.
Well, that was the next one.
Well, it's because we skipped some.
Oh.
We'll just continue to skip some.
Oh.
But if you want to talk about Mars, go ahead.
Have you seen the Glass Onion movie yet?
Yeah. I'm not a big fan of the Onion movies. I know there's a lot of layers to them, but I can't unpack them all.
Yeah.
Get it?
Yeah, I just, well, I got halfway through it. It's like, it's okay, but it's kind of stupid sometimes.
All right. So you want to talk Mars? Talk Mars.
I don't know anything about it. It's your subject. I wasn't here all day. I wasn't here all freaking week.
How do you know it's about Mars?
Because it says they do this on Mars, right?
What do they do on Mars?
Something about driving off road with an autonomous vehicle.
Oh, they do that on Mars, right?
Although it makes sense to me because, you know, it's all off road there because there's no roads.
And it's autonomous because there's nobody there that can control. By the time that they send a signal from Mars to Earth and then them tell them, don't drive off the cliff. Don't drive off the cliff. What just happened?
Yeah.
So Jeep thinks they're amazing because, look, they have off-road driving in Moab, Utah with Jeep vehicles.
Ooh.
It's our first time testing these off-road autonomy features in Moab. We are tackling these challenges that are in some sense greater than what you experience in on-road autonomy. And that for any engineer you know, makes your heart skip a beat.
Okay, again, they do this on Mars. They do this, you know, unless we're going to talk politics when the moon landing was fake. Right?
Yeah. Oh, no. That's not politics. That's stupid people versus. Never mind. I didn't call them stupid people. They're not necessarily stupid. They're misled.
Because I believe in conspiracy theories.
Yeah. Hey, just because you think somebody's trying to kill you doesn't mean they're not.
It's all about control.
Yeah.
Who going to control what? That's why we tell you guys, stop watching the news. Watch our show. Watch us.
Because we'll give it to you straight. Just, we'll tell you we don't know shit.
See, the don't know show. Just stop. Give yourself a break. Yeah. Let your brain calm down.
Hey, did you practice that line on Peggy before her boo-boo?
Did I practice the line?
Give yourself a break. But theoretically, it's not broken, right?
Not broken.
No.
Well, again, you go to the doctor, it's not broken, it's not sprained. But you can't move it, and it hurts like a son of a bitch.
Yeah, that sounds like a sprain to me.
That's not sucks. But
what it is. It's just a pulled muscle.
Yeah. So we don't talk politics, but you know, the Supreme Court just ended another session on Friday.
Yes.
They had a lot of laws come back and all that other stuff.
Yes.
Well, this is a lower court. Actually, it's not even a lower court. It's the FDA. And I have some bad news for you, Scott. And we're going to have to come up on some play on words. Anything plant-based can now be called milk.
Ooh.
Milk is not exclusive to...
Boo.
To cows or dairy.
Or boobies.
Does that just make your little heart curdle?
Yes.
I hope it doesn't sour you on the whole subject.
It does.
What do you got? Anything?
For plays on words?
Yeah.
I don't even want to think about it because...
You're a dairy guy. You should probably know them.
Yeah.
But soy, oat, almond, and other drinks that bill themselves as milk can keep using the name according to the Food and Drug Administration.
FDA, yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Plant-based beverages don't pretend to be from dairy animals, and that's why consumers aren't confused by the difference. So milk is not exclusive to, because hasn't coconut milk been around for a long time?
Yes.
And do people think that we just feed the cows coconuts?
Well, they do call it coconut milk. So, but then you say almond milk? Yeah.
They call it soy milk and cashew. Now,
if I recall correctly, two shows ago, didn't we have a machine that turned all this different things into milk?
Yeah, that's why I thought this was appropriate to follow up with this.
Okay. I don't have a problem with it because, you know, when I go to the grocery store, if it's almond milk, it's going to be $12. If it's moo milk, it's $3.
Oh, here we go. I got to share this.
I wonder if they're making almond milk ice cream. Not only that, goat milk is not from a cow.
Right. It's called goat milk. So this one right here, this shows that cow gives white milk and that cow gives chocolate milk, right?
Oh, of course. Everybody knows that.
Okay. Is this a chocolate milk cow too? Are these chocolate milk cows?
Actually, I think this, the one with the face right in the front, I think that is a root beer cow.
These are chocolate milk cows. Oh, the root beer floats cows?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, that was a chocolate, that's root beer float cow.
Sure.
Okay.
We took a page from the military's playbook.
So, kind of weird.
Weird. Which is okay.
So you couldn't come out of anything? Couldn't come out of any
I'm feeling better, but I only got 5 hours of sleep last night because I was so stressed. So I'm not doing bad, but I'm not there yet.
All right. Then playlists are a big thing now. They used to be cassette tapes.
Right.
When you and I were growing up,
we called them mixtapes. Yeah.
Mixtapes.
Yep.
Well, now on Spotify and stuff like that, you can create a playlist.
What's new about that?
Well, this Cosmopolitan article claims to have the 57 best songs about friendship.
Okay.
And you're a DJ, and I would like your opinion on the validity of Cosmopolitan's list of 57.
Okay.
Raise Your Glass by Pink. Friendship song?
Sure.
Or party anthem song?
Oh, I see where you're going with this.
Well, I'm not going anywhere. That's just this individual one. I don't know all the words to the song. But I think Raise Your Glass is more of a party anthem song than a...
I'd have to concur.
Okay. I don't know the words to 22 by Taylor Swift, so I don't know.
Honestly, I don't either.
So...
Although when I play it at the school dances, the girls go crazy.
Yeah. So we're all in this together from High School Musical. This one, 57 best.
Yeah.
We're all in this.
But at least I can understand it as being a friendship one, because it is basically about all being friends in school together.
That's the only part of the song I know, though.
Yeah.
We're all in this together. I don't know more words. I probably know more of the song then. We Can't Stop by Miley Cyrus. I should just play some of them and get us kicked off.
Yeah.
Boy Problems?
Well, yeah, because you're.
Sounds like a bashing song, not a.
Well, kind of, sort of, but you're bitching to your best buddies, your BFFs.
About romantic things?
Yeah. Now,
Bridge Over Troubled Water. Is that a friendship song? Like a bridge
over... Yeah, it kind of is.
Water, I would live...
I understand it.
I don't know. Girls by Rizzo, don't know that one. Do It by Chloe and Haley. I don't know that song. Okay. This one, friendship song.
Yeah. 100%.
I think that's that one. Isn't that the one from Toy Story? Or is that You Got a Friend in Me? Maybe that's a different one. I don't know.
Yeah.
What else? We got to be royals. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Use your click.
Oh, is that really? Okay.
Yeah, pretty much.
Cheetah Sisters, more like family stuff. Okay. New Rules, Dua Lipa. Don't know the song. You know these songs?
Some of them, not all of them. Like the last two, I did not.
This one, I agree with 100%. For Good. What it says is, because I know you, I was changed for good.
Okay.
And you have to say it both ways with the commas different spot. Because I know you, I was changed for good.
Okay. And
because I know you, I was changed for good.
Yes.
Evil to good, but yeah, so I like that one. Where You Lead, I'll Follow, Carole King. I'm gonna have to listen to all these songs. Lean On Me,
sure.
Lean On Me, what? I don't know, man. I don't know words today. Young, Dumb, and Broke. I guess so.
Could yeah. be.
We Are Young, more of an anthem than Friends. All the Single Ladies, yeah, I guess
they're yep. friends.
Without You. I don't know. Why do I not know these songs? I have to put this on my playlist and play this.
Yeah.
I'll Be There. True Colors by Cindy okay. Lauper.
Yeah.
I like the song. Is it a
so far
song?
I'm running about 80% of which ones I know and don't. Part of the problem is I'm so busy at the shows when I'm doing them.
You don't listen to the music. Just like our show. Yeah. Just like our show, you don't listen to the show.
Exactly.
Thank Same you. Problem. Scott doesn't listen to his show either.
Nope.
Wind Beneath My Wings, You Are the Wind Beneath My Wings. That is a friendship song.
Sure. 100%. Song.
Umbrella?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. You're the umbrella for all your buddies.
Say I'll Always Be Your Friend. Okay, I guess. I don't know this song. Hey Girl by Lady Gaga.
It was famous forever.
See You Again by Wiz Khalifa and Charlie Puth. Yeah. Yes. We Should Be Friends.
Sure. We should be.
My Little Pony.
Of course it is. 100%.
Okay.
Try, just give it a chance.
Yeah, okay, never mind.
Yeah.
Best Friends. Best Friend. Okay, sure. Fellowship. Okay. Your Hope. Okay, Olivia. I think I'd know more Olivia Rodrigo songs. I'm guessing a song called Friends by BTS. Gotta have
it. Should be about Friends, right?
Same thing with this one. Best Friends with Missy Elliott. Seven Rings by Ariana Grande is about friends.
Yeah. Who wants to give all our friends goodies, see?
Gee, thanks. Just bought it. I see it. I like it. I want it. I got it. Yeah. I want it. I got it. I want it.
She wants it. She's got it. She wants it. Okay. Time After Time. Be a true guy. No, that's True Colors. I don't know. My Best Friend. I don't know. God. Here it is. There's the one. You got a friend in me. What Friends Are For by Dionne Warwick.
You bet.
Wannabe Spice Girls. With a little help from my friends, the Beatles. Now we're getting to friend stuff. What About Your Friends by TLC? Yes. My Best Friend by Weezer. Remember this one?
No, my best friend.
Sorry, all Weezer songs sound alike. Friends by the Carters, don't know that one. You're My Best Friend by Queen. You know that one?
I do.
Sing it. Graduation, Friends Forever by Vitamin C. Boys Are Back in Town. Boys are back. The boys are back. Girl, Destiny Child, Friends in Low Places, Garth Brooks. Garth Brooks sucks. You know, I'm starting to like Garth Brooks less and less. Yeah, great entertainer, great singer, but God, what a dick. Started from the bottom. Put the whole back, Steve. What do you really think? Start from the Bottom by Drake.
Everybody knows what you think.
Yes, I'll Be There for You by the Rembrandts. Made famous by the theme song from Friends.
Thank you for being a fan.
Yep. Count on Me.
Bruno.
On the Ride. No New Friends, Khalifa. No New Friends. The reason that DJ Khaled has no new friends is because during his songs, all he does is yell, DJ Khaled! DJ! Yeah. If he yelled some of his other friends' names, he might have friends.
Exactly. But you know, when you're narcissistic, what do you expect?
I'm Only Me When I'm With You by Taylor Swift. Best Friend by Pharrell Williams. There you go.
Yay.
So, there's a lot of those songs I don't know, but I'm thinking more of those songs have to do with party anthems and stuff like that than being friends.
Yeah. It would be a lot more interesting if people played songs that meant something to them. Instead of just saying, oh, look at there's a list. This shit, I'll be good. I know I rambled there.
Yeah. So we'll do this one last subject. And then we'll go on to the word of the week. Because this is kind of a word thing.
Okay.
I'm going to cut these out of here. Cut this one out.
Cut it out.
Uh-oh.
Lack of sleep is catching up with me.
Scott up. And then...
next week should be a lot better.
What?
All the gigs are normal timed gigs, so I'm not going to be out till 3 o'clock in the morning for 2 days in a row, which I'm not used to anymore. I don't know. You remember back in the day, I used to come home sometimes when the sun was coming up. That was the way it was. But I'm in bed usually by 12:30 now.
I think I've screwed this up or something. I don't know what I've done.
Hate it when you do that, Steve.
There's the DJ Plus. Okay.
All right. Number 91, Shane Van Gisbergen won.
What?
What?
It's yes if you never teach them anything. Yes, if you never teach them anything.
What the heck are you talking about?
So open up the link and read the subject of the link. I don't know what I did with all the subjects I've been copying and pasting.
I don't know, but you just had the whole damn windows clicked up and I couldn't see anything.
I just screwed everything up. So
yeah,
I just deleted a bunch of subjects. Oh, well,
bad Steve.
We'll figure it out later. Maybe not. Who cares? I don't care.
So which one are we looking at that you moved?
I didn't move it. It's the last one in the list.
About the list?
No. Yes, if you never teach them anything. Why did this not work? What is going on?
Ah, now I see it. Common two-word phrase. This common two-word phrase is the worst thing a parent can tell a child, says education experts.
So what do you think a two-word phrase is? Shut up!
Oh, yeah, that would make sense.
You know what they tell them? They tell, now remember what they said.
Right.
What do you think a parent can tell a child? A child.
A child. So
what are we saying a child is? Someone who's old enough to understand your words, right?
Yeah, okay.
So you wouldn't want to explain them stuff, or you wouldn't want to tell them stuff that they don't comprehend or understand, right?
Correct.
Stop mixing those neutronic plutonium chemicals.
Okay.
Right?
Here's the two. Some kids phrases. Would probably understand that already.
Here's the two-word phrases. Ready? Calm sure. down. Calm down.
Yes. You only tell that to a hysterical person.
Okay, even a hysterical person, calm down.
It just infuriates
them. Do you
them.
Honestly think if they knew how to calm down, they would do it? I think calm down is the dumbest thing you can tell anybody. You need to calm down. Oh, sure. Those two words are going to be, I'm at my wit's end. I'm blowing up. I'm very excited. And thank God that you reminded me that I could calm down.
You're welcome, Steve.
See, you didn't even tell me to calm down.
You didn't
let me
need
go
to.
Off and be nuts. What you need to do is you need to teach people how to rephrase it, reframe it, right? So, Scott, when you're upset, what I want you to do is I want you to take a deep breath. Take a deep breath with me. Take a deep breath all the way in. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. 3, 2, 1. Now blow it out, relax, and let your shoulders drop. Let your shoulders drop. There you go. Okay, now don't you feel better? Okay, I guess not.
What?
But wouldn't that be better to do that with somebody instead of telling them to calm down? Oh, calm down. You shouldn't tell anybody to calm down.
No, because it's, calm down it's not an actual action. That is a phrase.
Well, there's no instruction to it. If
correct.
If you haven't been taught, let me see, calm down. Okay, I should take a breath. I should count to five. You've got to build some kind of structure on that. It's like telling somebody something that they don't understand to go do. I'd like you to go out there and I'd like you to adjust the timing to top dead center on that car.
Ooh, hey, that's from My Cousin Vinny.
Is it?
Yes.
Is it really?
Well, not the whole thing, the top dead center part.
Is it? I thought it was some kind of thing. Maybe it was.
He's being
it's a bullshit question because you can't do that because it had this or something like that. So
right.
You can't
and what is really? She says, well, if it was this year, it's blah, 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 three points off a top dead center.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that was that part of that, but yeah.
Yep.
But yeah, I mean, so unless you put it in context that people can understand, just saying words to anybody doesn't help.
Steve, get to eat. Go eat chupa.
Like what I'm trying to learn is what words I need to use to teach you how to use your ears to take in what we're talking about. Put a little retention to it so that you know what's going on.
What the hell? I am not Vincent Van Gogh. You can't have my ear.
Why not?
You can't. I want it. I want it. My glasses will fall off.
But here's the best part about me telling you about us talking about Joey Chetwood and last year about him putting the guy in the, you will not even remember that and won't go back and look at it. Number one. Number two, you still aren't doing your Reader's Digest homework.
No.
No. You don't like that.
No.
You know, and I said, okay,
fine, I'm waiting to get an A minus.
I said, fine, don't take the picture, but you at least bring a story. Bring a story that you've read, and you don't even do that.
No.
No.
No. You gotta wait till September. Uh-oh. He's writing something down. You know what that means. I can't wait to see it. Oh, he's drawing pictures too. Wait a minute. I know how to read. He's scribbling fast now and furiously. His microphone shaking. All right. Or are you typing? Are you typing or you're writing? You got to be writing, because if you were typing, I would have seen something by now. Okay. You know, it's not good to have dead air at the end of the show. Besides, you're supposed to be doing the word of the week now. Are you watching the show? Ours might be better than NASCAR. Okay. Steven. Wake up, Steven. Oh, you now he muted me. You're not going to make me do your word of the week or word of the week, are you? I'm on the nose. I got to do your word. Oh, wait a minute. It's a technology-driven word. That's your thing, not mine. Oh, wait. I'm a nerd too, right? Well, anyway, Steve came up with the word of the week, and it's called phubbing. What is phubbing, you may ask? Well, in today's technology-driven world, cell phones have become an integral part of our lives, offering convenience, connectivity, and endless possibilities. However, the excessive use of cell phones, particularly during interpersonal reactions, in other words, that's what he's doing, he's on his cell phone! I get it now. has given rise to a phenomenon known as phubbing. This is when you snub someone in favor of engaging with a mobile device, using the words snubbing, but with their phone, you know, PH instead of SN. This behavior has significant implications for both individuals and their relationships, especially when it comes to parent-child dynamics. Wait a minute. We just talked about parent-child dynamics with, you know, shut up! And you shut up by yourself. You did a good job, Steve.
I was phubbing you.
You're phubbing me.
Phone snubbing you.
That's right. But you didn't let me see the phone. That's what threw me off. I literally thought you were writing something. See?
Because I was phubbing you.
You were phubbing me. So now you all know what phubbing means.
But you said it'd have to do it the word a week, and I went.
Yes, so well, that's why.
It's like a charades, too, then.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
It means that somebody farted. You're on point. Bingo.
No.
Yeah. What do you think it means?
Thank you for watching.
And if you feel our show is not a bad life decision, oh my God, you just made this a bad life decision.
Please subscribe, like, watch our other shows and channels. Come on back next week. Enjoy your 4th of July. Do not blow your fingers off or your face off or your head off. Let the professionals do the shows. I did them for many years. It's much more fun to go sit back and enjoy them. Let them take all the risk. And plus, in most places, they're illegal. Plus, with the drought going on, you're going to start fires.
Yeah.
So just go enjoy, relax. Go enjoy your cola ketchup. Chup. Colachup.
Colachup, that is the dumbest thing in the whole world.
No, it's not, but it's dumb.
No.
We've seen dumber. Yes, we have.
No, I don't think I have. But live every day. Don't live on the 4th of July having Colachup. But live every day, and we'll see you on the next show.
Be genuinely positive, live and love life, and have a good one. Be crazy. Hey, don't you step amazing.